challenger on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing black trunks with red trim, fighting out of Chicago, Illinois. He weighed in 231 pounds. His record stands at 31 wins, only one loss, 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, he is making his second attempt at the heavyweight championship of the world. Please welcome the IBF number one ranked heavyweight contender, introducing Von Shake and Bake B. And his opponent across the ring really needing no introduction to his hometown of Atlanta, nor the world over. On my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white trunks with purple and red trim, proudly representing Atlanta, Georgia. He weighed in at 217 pounds. With a record of 35 wins, 3 losses, he has 25 wins coming by way of knockout. Please welcome the former undisputed cruiserweight world champion, the former undisputed heavyweight world champion, only the second man in history to have captured the heavyweight crown 3 times. Ladies and gentlemen, here is boxing's warrior spirit, the IBF and WBA heavyweight champion of the world, introducing the one and only Evander, the real deal, Holyfield.
All right, gentlemen, come on out.
All right, gentlemen, listen up. I'll be the third man in the ring this evening in charge of this world title bout at all times. When I give you the command to break, you break cleanly. If you score a knockdown, go to the neutral corner. Do not come out till I signal. Avoid the use of your head as a weapon. No rabbit punches or low blows. I want you to protect yourself at all times, shake hands, and come out fighting at the bell.
Despite contrary belief, Holyfield says he has not been distracted by his countless appearances and interviews promoting this event here in his hometown. He says he's in great shape, sleeps 10 hours a day. The only day he missed in 9 weeks of training was last Friday, the day his son, Elijah Jebediah, was born. This afternoon, he watched his two other sons play youth league football. Pretty good indication of how relaxed and confident he is. Word has it, Vaughn Bean's own sparring partners were having their way with him this past week. Look for hard shots to his body by Holyfield. Bean doesn't have much of a punch. Okay hand speed, lateral movement. Has a tendency to drop his guard after throwing. That's an engraved invitation for an excellent counterpuncher like Evander Holyfield.
Time.
Brian Gary, a veteran from Tampa, working his first heavyweight title fight, brings him in. Here we go.
Well, Evander's going to come out and take his time. He's not going to be overexcited by the crowd and want to impress too much. He's going to do what he has to do. He's going to find his range, gauge the speed and power or lack thereof of Bean, and then get to work.
Well, as he says, he's a thinking fighter now. There's a nice combination. Open the evening like saying, here we are for real. This is a heavyweight championship.
So Bean will throw one or two, and Holyfield will throw four or five back.
Bean got a little right in there, snuck one in to the jaw of Holyfield. But as you fight fans know, oftentimes Holyfield loves the wake-up call. He'll thrive after getting hit.
Don't post him, Evander. Don't guide him. Watch your head.
Here's a beautiful right hand by Evander Holyfield.
Evander means business.
Yeah, you can tell in the face in that exchange, and he means business. And that was down to that extra 17 pounds he's carrying. Ouch.
Holyfield, like he said, going to the body.
Very focused and very purposeful. Bean cannot win this fight backing up. I mean, this is not another Michael Moore.
Yeah, Moore made Bean think he belonged there, which incensed Teddy Atlas, who quit Moore after the fight. Hard to believe Holyfield would let that happen.
And in keeping with Bobby's predictions, he punches one, two, and out. Bean, Bobby's prediction was if he doesn't punch more than one, two, and out, he's in big trouble than Bobby.
He doesn't have to worry about the out because he'll be on the wrong end of it.
Yeah. Not on the back
he's doing
of the net,
what
man,
you said he shouldn't do. One, two,
Holyfield always seems to find the right formula, knows what tools to bring to each fight. As Bean tries to dig to the body.
Don't hold him, Vander. Don't hold him, Vander. Step out of here. Come on. Don't hold him out of here. Come on, nice and clean, Vander. Don't hold him.
Minute to go in round one, scheduled for 12 for the IBF WBA Heavyweight Championship.
Get him up, Vaughn. Get it up, Vaughn. Get it up.
Low blows by Vaughn Bean being cautioned by Brian Gary.
Right now, Vaughn Bean is in a survival mode. He's just looking to block shots, maybe get one or two of them, but he is looking strictly at this as defense. Just defend.
But that's what he did against Moore. He stunk out the joint. He does it against this guy. He won't have a chance to stink out the joint. He will be on his back.
Give it up, man.
Oh, what a left hook by Holyfield.
It's a nice double left hook under and over with the lead right hand. Bean covers up pretty well, but he cannot be effective going backwards and holding his head.
It's up. Quick punch, Vaughn. Quick punch.
Oh, those shots to the body, Bobby. Those shots to the body.
Oh, a right uppercut by Evander Holyfield that scores to the chin of Bean.
It was a nice left hook and a right uppercut. He threw a beautiful, terrific counter combination.
Mike Tyson called Holyfield the best counter puncher he'd ever seen as round one ends.
Check this out, boss. That jab. Everything off the jab. You're working beautiful. Just keep showing in that jab, though. Double up with it. Okay. Go ahead, Doc.
He's bending over. You can hit him with uppercuts. Okay. Trapping, making, feigning. Make him put his head there and then shove it in there. Okay.
But it got to come off the jab first. Everything off the jab first.
Water.
Yeah. Spit bucket right in front of you, baby.
Set it up, baby. Set it up.
And right, let's take a look at the uppercut, just what Don told him to throw because he's bending over. His other, right on the button. His other manager says, don't forget the jab. Well, I think he's doing everything. He's jabbing him, he's uppercutting him, he's doing everything.
Bean leaves himself open after throwing. And Holyfield comes across with beautiful right counter punches. Bean said his best punch is his right cross in round one. Bean even throwing by Mike Count.
Well, he threw what was an attempt like that, an overhand right, but it's not powerful, it's not straight, it's not solid.
Holyfield continues to dig into the body. If he said with the his game plan.
Well, that will slow Bean down because he's so
Bean off balance, stumbles into the ropes, no knockdown.
Well, as they come close, Bean's going to look to hold. He doesn't want to trade with Evander on inside, and he can't trade with him outside. So I think he should get inside Evander, work the body, and come up and take a shot.
Beautiful straight left there by Holyfield. Missed with the right. Bean bleeding a bit from the nose.
See, he's not pressing Evander. He's not pushing him. He's not making Evander do anything that Evander doesn't want to do. You can't beat Evander that way. You got to force a pace. You have to do something to take him out of his game because he is a smart fighter, very well conditioned, and very well mentally conditioned.
He's even jabbing to the body. He's jabbing to the body as well as the head, and he's coming in with hard hooks to the body, hard uppercuts to the body.
Bean's game. He's coming forward, and he could find trouble soon.
Right now, it appears that Bean has one of those tactics to wait off, swing and hold. Swing, maybe hit Evander and then clinch. And that works for some people, but it's not going to work here tonight.
Bean again trying to work on the inside, but Holyfield withstands that one. No combination of the body by Holyfield. Well, he has to take the starts out of you. Bean futilely comes back.
I don't know if you can hear our drivers in the boy. They're thumping like a bass drum. All you can hear is thump, thump every time Holyfield punches to the body.
Ferocious driving punches to the body by Evander Holyfield. That's what Don Turner wants.
It's something that's key. Vaughn Bean doesn't even with a wild swing hit hard enough to get Evander's respect. Evander just walks right through. So he hits Evander with the hardest thing he has, and Evander just smiles and says, no big deal.
That's all you got? The look from the eyes of Holyfield.
Hold on, just step out.
Well, we do come again. Bean is a light puncher. And Holyfield's taken a lot harder shots than those in his career. It'll take an awful lot to get him down. Bean just winding up, but he's going to leave himself wide open.
That's the first time he's taken more than two shots. He took seven shots in a row. That's the first time Bean did that.
And now Holyfield looks mad.
Bean at least took a shot himself.
A left hand by Bean.
Nice left hand.
And Evander Holyfield stands right in with a left uppercut to the body.
I got you, Joe. I got you.
And one of those punches just took a little bit out of Holyfield for a second.
So check it out. Mr. Toomey.
You gotta fire with speed when he gets there. Rip it up the middle when you get it. Hey, put him up and down.
Ron.
You're hanging. Don't load up.
Ron, I want to see you with this guy. Listen to me.
Let's take a look at Bean as he's beginning to take real punishment from. Watch the body shots coming in here. As soon as he finishes on top, Holyfield goes right down to the body because his whole modus operandi is to kill the body. Bobby.
You know, Bean, remarkably, he was very ineffective in the first round. Throws a nice level here, gets Evander's attention. I think Evander misjudged that shot. Hit him clean in the, like, nose, forehead area. It was a decent left hook, and he followed up with four or five shots, something Bean has been not doing.
Holyfield clearly establishing the pace of this fight, taking control from the start, although he got a little bit stunned late in round two. Here we go to round three.
Well, at least Bean fought, and he fought in the style Bobby said he had to, combination of punches. That's the only way I see him beating Holyfield, or even winning a round where he can punch five, six punches while Holyfield is not punching. That's the way he, that's a good defense. But just to back away from Holyfield is to ask for a slow death.
Style and leverage were keys for Holyfield against Tyson. He showed he was the tougher of the two against Michael Moore in their rematch.
Holyfield is getting into that little rhythm. You see the little bounce? He's getting himself into his little rhythm. It's like a Terry Norris type of rhythm. When he gets that rhythm going, he's coming forward. His timing is better. His punches are delivered sharper, crisper, and on time.
Now he looks to be stalking Bean. Bean just loading up with that right hand. The crowd beginning to chant Holyfield. There's a sneaky right uppercut by Bean. That got it to the chin of Holyfield.
Get that head off of him. Get that head off of him.
The warning of headbutting to Vaughn Bean.
Come on.
You heard Brian Garrett stop butting him.
Screaming you hear from the corners, Butch Lewis is giving a whole load of advice. Look at this.
Combination by Vaughn Bean. Back comes Holyfield to the body. Vaughn Bean continues to show that he is game.
Vaughn Bean is doing something smart to an inside. See, he's laying in one or two. Holyfield's blocking it, and then Bean is holding. See? And there's no way for Vander then to get off the proper counter. It's going to be very frustrating. It's going to cause mistakes. See, and the inside, Evander's not being allowed to even work. And that's going to be important because from the outside, Bean's hands are up, and he's kind of quick and jumps in.
Here's a grazing right hand just missed by Evander Holyfield. A straight right by Holyfield on the inside. Again, Bean stands right in there.
Now Evander's closing the gap. He's fighting more like a Tyson style. Hands up, staying tight. Bending his legs and ripping on the inside tight.
And they're hard, hard, short shots, the kind that really take your heart out. The combinations he threw then were very hard.
And he truly is the thinking man's fighter. As this fight unfolds, he's thinking what he needs to do, how to close down Vaughn Bean.
Now, these shots, Bobby and Freddie, seem to be getting wider. He looks to be tiring here in round three. And of course, to the advantage of Holyfield with a vicious straight left to the face. A combination of the head by Holyfield.
He's not one shot at a time. It's three, it's four.
Look at
five.
The left hands by Holyfield. And now a right hand, and Brian Gary steps in.
Let's go.
What was that?
Well, he set the break and started to break him, and Holyfield has started a free hand. He has the right to throw that hand.
And that draws the ire from this capacity crowd, right off the top of the head by Vaughn Bean. Every once in a while, he scores.
But it's not a significant shot. It's not a debilitating shot.
Don't wait for him to throw it. Catch him before he throw it. He got to wind up. He's throwing it from here.
Okay.
You let him lay on you, too.
All right, let's see some of the infighting. He got a little tiny bit on the edge of dirty here. They're not dirty. They're just getting tough with each other inside. They're bumping heads a little bit, not too bad. But it's getting hard in the inside, and the guy's punishing and taking the punishment is Bean. Bean is getting killed inside. And see all the rest, and here's the referee trying to establish some order and break them clean, and of course, a little dirtiness, not much.
I've been pretty tough on Vaughn Bean heading into this fight, but I'll give him credit. He's showing heart. He's hanging in there against the world champ.
He's doing the best he can with what he has, Steve. He's frustrating Evander a little bit. And Don Turner's giving perfect advice. He said he's got to load up. He's got to throw it over the top. Just fire one down the middle. Get to him first.
He said he's throwing that wide right, so take advantage of that. The crowd of 41,000 was heard for the first time earlier, urging Holyfield to move forward. Let's see what happens here.
As of right now, he's doing better than Buster Douglas did against him. I mean, at least he's holding his own. He's not running away and getting killed. He's fighting.
Here's the online scoring. Holyfield in a shutout after three.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt about that. I don't think it's wrong. It's going to give him another.
You know, Evander said you're only as good as your opponent. I think you're only as good as the reputation your opponent has when you beat him and take it from him. And one doesn't have much of a reputation. Should he lose tonight, which I believe he will, his reputation stock may even go up just by fighting as much as he has, and he hasn't really fought that much.
Hit hard shots to the midsection by Evander Holyfield, who every once in a while does fight to the level of his opponent. Questions of overconfidence coming in, looking ahead perhaps to Lennox Lewis. The 10-month layoff. The most feeling that given the competition level here of Vaughn Bean, those were not valid issues.
Bean has shown that his chin is pretty good. He hasn't really been hit with the monster clean shot yet. He covers well, keeps his hands up. On the inside, he's kind of annoying. He's bullying in, trying to use his weight to shove Evander and throw the shots over the top. They're not real solid punches, but they're doing something.
Well, perhaps adding those 15-plus pounds was a good strategy for Vaughn Bean. More weight for Holyfield to push around.
Keep it up.
A low blow there. That was right on the belt.
On the capital B of Bean.
That was a nice counter right here.
By Evander Holyfield. An effective combination in the head.
Just like we showed the tape, he rocked and rolled. Bean threw a jab, he rocked on it, fired a right hand.
Oh. Very good punches. Good shots to the body and over to the head by Holyfield.
And now the crowd sensing the urgency off those rocking shots by Evander Holyfield. They're all ready to stand. But then all of a sudden it stops.
You can see in Bean's eyes that he's closing in on desperation.
Yeah, but Bobby, give him credit. Give him credit.
I give him credit. I've been in with that man. I know how he punches.
Give him credit. Give Bean credit. There's nothing to laugh at. He stayed here at respectable distances making a fight. Not much, but he's fighting back.
Oh, a miss there by Evander Holyfield. Beautiful duck under move by Bean defensively to avoid that missile. Final seconds of round four, and it looks like Vaughn Bean has made it through another round in his second world championship fight.
Watch your head on him now.
He don't like it here. He don't like it there.
Baby, you can do this. He don't like it here. When you hit him with that body shot, he lift his leg up. You understand it? You hit him right here. He lift his leg up. He's stretched on that shot.
Holyfield wants to apply the pressure, keep Vaughn Bean going backward, just like he did with Mike Tyson. Keep punches in his face, basically ambush him on his back to the ropes. That's what he likes to do. Vaughn Bean would have nowhere to go. He goes to step back. There are the ropes. Evander cleans up on him. There's no way to escape with his back to the ropes like that. To his credit, Bean punches back, but Evander again works him to the ropes where Bean can't run, hide, sneak out. He has to hold.
The two treading big blows halfway through the last round with the champion displaying more power and more accuracy as we head into round five. How many of you thought that this fight would go this long?
Not me. I had just four rounds on my scorecard that I was going to keep scoring. I didn't think it was going to go past that, so I'm drawing some more down here, 5, 6, and 7.
So once again, Vaughn Bean stopped goes up. No matter what happens from this point on.
I thought three with a maximum of six. I'll be real surprised at this point if he still goes the distance.
He's lasted longer than Mike Tyson did in their second fight, Holyfield Tyson. There's a left hook by Vaughn Bean that connected to the face of Holyfield.
Right on the face.
But he's loading up with that right and throwing wide, Bean, and that could really get him in trouble. But he continues to fire away, but Holyfield comes back. Holyfield's punches are harder.
Holyfield clearly the better puncher, is the sharper puncher. His hand speed is not a huge difference there. But Vaughn Bean is not throwing 231 pounds in his punches. He's swinging with a lot of arm.
And Vaughn is, Vaughn Bean busier than I thought he'd be as well. He's throwing a lot of punches. Holyfield taking a big deep breath, a step back, looking to regroup.
Almost quit fighting here for a while. I mean, all of fighting has been by Bean in the last 45 minutes, seconds or a minute. Holyfield's like taking a break.
Left uppercut by Bean that sent Holyfield back a little bit.
Evander taking a little rest, it looks like, watching his man, letting Bean throw some punches, maybe looking for an opening where Bean loads up that he can time him and clean him up. Evander's not jabbing. Simple jab was so effective for him in the first 3-4 rounds. That's all he needs to do. Work off that jab. Stuff the jab. Just stuff it.
He's looking like the former Evander Holyfield here in this round, not the one we've seen of late, where he has been more patient and intelligent. And Boxmore using the jab, smacking left hand there by Vaughn Bean that got through. This is Bean's best round.
To a certain degree, I think Bean's answered some of the critics, but you know, this is the only round where he's actually offered up enough to try and come close to winning a round. And if this is all he has, I don't know if the critique will be finished.
That's a good round. Good round for Bean. That's the first one he's won. He's done all the fighting, and Evander took time off when he's tired or bored. I don't know, but he didn't fight.
Well, let's turn back the clock to November 23rd, 1991, right here in Atlanta. Some very anxious moments for Evander Holyfield. Bert Cooper, a late replacement for Mike Tyson, out with injured ribs, had the champion in trouble in round three, and he nearly took the title away. Only the ropes were able to keep Holyfield up. Some disputed that Mills Lane wrongfully gave Holyfield a standing eight count, which wasn't in the rules, but he actually called it an official knockdown. Therefore, an eight count was correct. Holyfield came back to score a seventh round TKO and thus avert disaster, as he really poured it on against Bert Cooper on that night in 1991 here in the city of Atlanta. And right now, Vaughn Bean is trying to answer the call against Evander Holyfield in Atlanta about 8 years later. Here we go in round six. There's a lot of moisture in the corner of Vaughn Bean as water just drips from Bean's black trunks.
And a lot of ice in it. They just overloaded him.
That's just too much water.
Yeah, it's a little amateurism, and they shouldn't do that. It's not going to help them at all. Well, let's see if Holyfield has come back into the building and decided to fight the next round.
He took round five off.
And that should have given a big boost to Bean. I mean, Bean should come out here and say, oh, yeah, well, maybe this guy's getting tired.
Some of the judges may have given that last round to the challenger.
I did. I gave it to him, and I
I think Vaughn Bean did enough to win that round, too, Freddie. Stevens trying to set it. Holyfield took the first 2 minutes off.
And Holyfield bouncing around, going back to his scientific style, being patient here. Let's see if he shoots that jab out a little bit to set up the right hand. Keep an eye on Vaughn Bean's left. After throwing, if he drops the guard. Bean is landing with that overhand right to the head of Holyfield.
And Holyfield is missing in return.
Nice uppercut and overhand by Vaughn Bean.
And this crowd is getting anxious by the moment. All of a sudden, some nervous faces here at the Georgia Dome. Remember, this is Holyfield's homecoming, a celebration that has lasted for quite some time heading into this fight.
Oh, Vaughn! About a week. Come on, man. Come on. You all right, man? All right.
Warning from referee Brian Gary, 16-year veteran from Tampa. Low blows by Bean.
Van is not using a jab, and I don't really understand it. I don't know what he's doing now. He's just walking to Bean with his hands up and blocking shots. Maybe he's forcing somewhat of a firefight. Maybe he's letting one Bean unload some things, saving some energy. I'm not sure what he's doing.
Well, what he's doing is letting Bean take the round away from him again, letting him take the place, because Bean is getting brave. He just let Bean off the hook and got him brave.
I never thought I'd be saying this, but suddenly Holyfield is doing what Moore did. He's making Bean believe he belongs here.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
I don't know. This is another one of those kind of fights where Holyfield just wears out. And, you know, that's a question we couldn't answer because he looks so good against Tyson.
And the question has to be raised at this point. Could this be the night Holyfield turns into an old fighter? He certainly didn't look old in his last fight, taking more a number of times and route to that victory.
You can only go to the till so many times. You come up with the clean water. I talk about it all the time. And you can't tell when that day is going to come until it happens to you. And that is an awful feeling. Take it from someone that knows.
Don't hold me there.
But Vaughn is leading this round. He is doing the fighting. And Holyfield is just covering up and letting him do it. I mean, he just gave him two rounds like a big gift.
Hey, listen, when you're on this side, you got to run that stuff and step around, boss. You can't stand
right
in front of this guy.
And how Bean is dominating the action and taking the action away from Holyfield, who seems content to take these hammering shots, missing wild shots like that, and back comes Bean. Bean is getting braver by the moment. Look at that uppercut right between his guard. And then another hook, and then another right hand. Bobby, take a second look.
You know, it's another look at it, and Vaughn Bean is taking the play away from Evander right now. You see a little less speed on Evander's shots, a little less power, and less of them. Bean throwing more of them and getting a little braver with each combination. Another clean right hand. Holyfield misses again. Come inside. He's, you know, it's almost as if he wants to trade with him, whereas in the first four rounds, he didn't want to go anywhere near Evander.
Vaughn Bean not afraid to exchange with Evander Holyfield, and you heard, once again, the words of Don Turner into the ear of Evander Holyfield, or what's left of his ear. You took that round off, and that's two rounds now he's taken off.
He took two rounds off, that's right. Well, let's see, I can't believe that that is because he's tired. He must.
Well,
we've got it 4-2. I got 56-58, Holyfield ahead, four rounds to two.
That's the story online, 4-2 Holyfield halfway through. What do you say, Bob?
It's pretty obvious that that's how it's gone. It's just, that simple. First four, not even close. The last two, Evander just didn't do anything. He just let Vaughn win by default.
The fans gave Vaughn B rounds 5 and 6.
Either Evander's exhausted or he just completely just lost everything he had. I don't understand. First four rounds, he came out very focused, very purposeful, very accurate, good shots. Didn't overthrow, didn't unload too much.
Well, perhaps he is too overconfident coming to this fight. All the distractions, maybe taking their toll. Low blow caution again to Vaughn Bean. From the third man of the ring, Brian Gary.
Holyfield is not able to do what he wants to do. He's getting frustrated. Now, we know he's got a huge heart. Huge heart, and he's got a champion's heart. But I can hardly believe what I'm seeing. He just like abandoned what he did the first four rounds. He's hoping to land that one killer shot.
Don't hold him, Evander.
Well,
don't hold his head down. Don't guide him.
I wonder if he'll burn himself out with all these mandatories in his quest to unify the championship.
Don't guide him.
Right now, on a day like this, looking like this, first four rounds, he looked terrific. But looking like this, he can't beat Lennox Lewis fighting like this.
Well, fights, as you know, Bobby, are 12 rounds. So let's see what happens all the way through.
That's assuming Lennox Lewis gets by Zeko Mavrovich next week.
Your styles make fights. It's amazing. You take a fighter like Roberto Duran, who beats Sugar Ray Leonard, who goes the distance with Hager in a close fight. Both Hager and Leonard both knock out Tommy Hearns, and Hearns starches Duran in two rounds. So the style set up for certain people to just be frustrated.
You're holding, Vaughn. Go home.
going.
A right hand by Vaughn Bay that stung Evander Holyfield here late in round seven. Holyfield trying to come back, but Bean trying to hold on to
him. Bean pretty good here. And Bean is holding on as best he can. He's just diving into Evander now and holding on.
Bean was hurt, but he came back all right. He didn't. I don't know if that was a mouthpiece he kicked out.
I don't know what it was, but there was a piece of the camera.
You see, you got to give Bean credit. He's not scared. He took a little shellacking, and he's right back. He just no respect. He's fighting. You got to like Bean off this fight.
Bobby, the first to admit I was wrong about him in terms of his heart and courage.
Wow. Hard round to judge.
When you hit him, get about double it. Bean, bang up top, right back.
All right, let's take a look at how he made a comeback. Evander made a comeback. That was a good right hook to get him in trouble. Left uppercut now here. But that's back of the head, Bobby. That was back of the head. And I don't think
we have Bobby another look at it. Evander rocks here on a right hand bang. He rocks back out and he catches him with a nice uppercut. And then another left
now
uppercut.
Watch.
There you can see Bean's eyes were a little shot. And he just diving into Holyfield trying to hold on. Look, just diving in at all costs to hold on. That's a man that's hurt.
Bean winning the fans over, sitting behind his corner in unison. They were chanting Bean, Bean, round eight.
Watch your head.
Vaughn Bean going past seven rounds for only the second time in his career.
Bean said he was confident he was going to knock Holyfield out. He was very sure about it, as if it was almost a foregone conclusion.
Yes.
Something I thought that was absurd, but he is in there, and he is trying, and he is making the fight of it.
Gentlemen,
Evander's allowing it.
I remind you, gentlemen, we're in showtime. That's the Bermuda Triangle of upsets. I mean, we can fall off a million upsets we've had. I mean,
are we looking at Carlos Monzon over Nino Benvenuti in Rome? Gene Fulmer over Sugar Ray Robinson in New York? This one would probably step up higher than that if Bean could prevail.
On one side, I told that Bean had to close the gap, which he's doing. Evander's letting him. He had to fight effectively on the inside. Evander's letting him. He had to get underneath the jab where the body's doing that too. Evander's letting him get away with an awful lot.
And all of a sudden, Evander is flat-footed. All of a sudden, he's not bouncing around having a good time.
And for as big as this crowd is here in Holyfield's backyard, not making much of a difference. Not a factor here.
And Bean doing everything that Bobby said he had to do. Punching in bunches and sticking close inside and doing his work. Bobby, he heard you because he's working just what you said.
Well, we talked to him before the fight. If he did it with Moore, he could have won. And Evander is certainly not. Michael Moore is a much more active fighter, but not here. First four rounds, Bean wasn't in anything. Now, all of a sudden, it's a close fight.
Well, in case you're counting, this is Evander Holyfield's 665th round of professional boxing. We wonder, is it one round too many?
You won't know until this is all over. And this looks like it's shaping up into a close fight.
Unbelievable. As we enter the final minute of round eight.
Look at it. He has no legs. He's being pushed back by a Jelly Bean here. He's being pushed back. Look at Evander going back. Now, that guy doesn't look like he should be able to push Evander Holyfield back.
Well, you know what he's doing? He's getting his center of gravity a little lower than Evander's. He's bending and he's just driving with his legs. And Evander's letting him.
He's using all of those 231-plus pounds to drive forward on Evander Holyfield.
Evander rocked him a little bit with an uppercut. And Bean took time out. Bean's fighting very smart. He got hurt. He just took time out. And now he's back again.
Yeah, that's working for Evander.
Holyfield beginning to score with more regularity now.
But he's right at the end of the round. He can't pull his round out unless he does something really spectacular. He lost another round.
Well, I didn't give this round to Bean, but in the last minute, Evander worked more than Bean, except his last few seconds.
Oh, this is short right hook by Evander Holyfield on the counter. As the bell sounds to end round eight.
Take a deep breath. Let it out slow.
He's doing it.
Wide open.
And then put him in there.
Put up on him. Please, don't you see that?
I understand more than reason.
When are you going to stop? When are you going to take a point?
Let's go.
Sit down, baby.
Sit down, baby.
Come on, baby. Too many people talking in Bean's corner for him to hear anything, but they put the end swell on his eye. I didn't see any swelling there, but that's a good idea to keep it from swelling.
It's Nelson, Bryson, John Bate, Joe Frazier also in that corner. Well, Holyfield's flurry at the end of that eighth round may have won it for him as we enter round number nine.
I'm not one of those guys that likes to think that a guy can win 2.5 minutes of a round and one guy can steal it in the last 20 seconds. I don't buy that. I mean, Bean outworked him the whole time.
And now the crowd, Kearney, trying to urge Holyfield on.
Look at this. He just keeps pumping. Bean keeps the assault going. That's what's winning this thing. He's round by rounds for him.
Holyfield won the first four rounds rather easily than all of a sudden Vaughn Bean with that heart.
Well, he gave
able to come back.
Holyfield quit fighting for two rounds and got him brave.
Vaughn Bean's getting tired too. Watch his right hand as he brings it over.
Well, it should be time. Bobby's doing all the fighting here. He's doing all the pushing, and he's pushing Holyfield back and pushing him along the ropes. Look what he's doing to him on the ropes.
The leaning also taking its toll on Holyfield's body. That was a head bar by Vander Holyfield on purpose. He pulled him in on him to smack heads. Did you see that?
Oh, he did.
I did
he
not. Did. I did not catch
that. I
was,
did.
That was a dirty tactic by Holyfield.
That's desperation. Holyfield must be feeling desperate. He's in a corner, he looks like he's breathing very heavily. He looks like he's having that little tired breathing that you see in a fighter.
The referee, Brian Gary, was not able to pick up on that. They did in the corner of Vaughn Bean, and from this angle, it sure looked like Holyfield took him bodily and pulled him to his head to try to headbutt him.
Well, he just warned Bean about the head, so that must be an interesting reversal of fortunes.
Well, that's a lucky break for Holyfield. Holyfield, tired, that was an off-balance. Bean was not staggered there.
No, and Bean is doing the punching.
Get him up, Bean. Keep him up.
Holyfield now looks very tired, exhausted.
Bean does too, but Bean's just holding on. Bean wants nothing to do with my inside, which is kind of smart.
You'll recall headbutting was Mike Tyson's complaint, largely against Evander Holyfield. And now Vaughn Bean has something to talk about. Uppercuts. Landing by Evander Holyfield on the inside.
Bean has even thrown a punch in the last 25 seconds. There's one. But he's doing little tiny pit pass. At least Evander's taking something up on the inside.
There's a heavy right hook. But a counter punch. Hard punches to the face by Evander Holyfield. Countering.
Yeah, those are two great punches by Holyfield. Great punches.
And again, a late flurry.
Nah, that was
by Holyfield.
And he fought the whole round. I gave that round to Holyfield.
Well, if not, he may have stolen
back.
It.
Listen to this. We can take this. This ball has
it, man.
If you want it, cut it loose. Cut it loose, Vita. Please. Cut it loose. It's there for us. It's there for us to take it. It's there for us to take it.
We want it. We work too hard.
Move it, John.
It's there for us to take it.
Get your feet out in front of me. Get your feet out in front of me.
It's there for us to take it. Hands up, Sydney.
You know that?
He's open for the rip up the middle. Double up right hand.
You got me. Right, baby. Get some deep breaths. Get some deep breaths, baby. Right uppercut.
All right, let's take a look at that incident where he seems to push him off and then butts him. See there?
No, you know what?
That was not.
That really not. Look at that again. He was just trying to get him off. He moved his head to the side. Just get him off.
Well, I beg to differ.
Watch the ice, Steve.
The ice comes flying our way. Once again, a lot of moisture in the Bean corner. They told Vaughn Bean, they screamed it in his face. He's open. Holyfield's open for a rip up the middle. Go up the middle.
Evander is the jab. See the jab? Look at this. This is all he had to do.
Now he looks like, now he's bouncing. Now he looks like Holyfield up the front.
Online scoring, Holyfield up 5-4. Here comes Vaughn Bean.
I have Holyfield up 6-3.
I have it 5-4.
Annoyed too if I was a Vander Holyfield. Amazingly, we're in round 10. And listen to this crowd turning. That's not Holyfield they're chanting, that's Bean.
I got you.
You see here now, we haven't talked about it this last 15, 20 seconds. All Bean did was retreat. Now he throws a couple of punches.
They're blocked by Holyfield. Vaughn Bean looking to become a real-life Rocky Balboa here tonight in Atlanta in the backyard of Evander Holyfield. Can he pull off the colossal upset here?
Well, to me, it was I'd tell you, you could just make it to 12 on a decision, but here, it looked like the decision could be in question if he pulls it out. Hey, he's number one. From now on, I'm going to take my hat off to him. He is number one.
Well, it was incredulous how he became number one, but now he's showing.
Evander Holyfield, I believe Evander Holyfield underestimated my durability and didn't train for me, which is why I got tired, and I believe he did the same thing here tonight. He didn't do it to Mike Tyson twice. He was ready. He was ready to go to distance.
He's obviously taken Bean too lightly. And all the distractions during the weight are taking their toll.
He hurt Bean.
And Bean goes down. The Rocket Cup finished him off. He goes down. He's writhing around in agony.
He hurt Bean on the way in. And he fell into the ropes.
Six.
Can he make it up in time? Yes. He makes it up at seven.
Come to me.
But can he survive the final 30 seconds? It's the first time he's ever been knocked down in his career. Now, Holyfield.
Uppercut is what Holyfield needs to throw. It's what got him in trouble. He just steps in with the uppercut. Evander's tired now. He's not thinking. He's looking to throw the big right hand. There's the uppercut.
But he's got the second one here in the final 10 seconds. The crowd going wild.
Strictly adrenaline, Steve.
He's going to make it to the bell.
There's the bell. And Vaughn Bean will make it to the championship round.
As he comes out, he gets an uppercut. That was like moron. He's coming out from the ropes and gets hit. Of course, it's protect yourself.
He got stunned with the left hand. You'll see. Watch him get stunned with that little right uppercut there. He got stunned a little bit. He started to lean in. Another uppercut. Stunned him a little bit. That hook. Staying on top of it. But that last right uppercut's clearly the one who did it.
But he was all tied up in the ropes down there, Bobby. I mean, he wasn't standing up for that. So he's, hey, protect yourself at all times is illegal, sir.
He unleashed it just as the referee was trying to get in there. Now the fans are into it. Round number 11.
And that took this fight out of the realm of any doubt. In case there's any funny shenanigans with the judges, I don't think they can make too much funniness out of that. That was an 8-10 round.
Well, none of the judges are from Atlanta.
I'm not sure it's going to matter. I wouldn't want to try and judge this fight with Bean being on the floor, judge it the other way, give it to Bean, and then try and get out of this arena.
Oh, a straight right hand by Evander Holyfield to the face of Vaughn Bean.
See, Evander Holyfield, on a good day, has five or six more shots in there before Bean even gets close to recovery.
A huge overhand right by Bean, and Holyfield showing what a great chin he's got. Well, they are really trading some heavy shots. Slapping left to the hook there by Vaughn Bean. Holyfield comes roaring back, pressing the attack. Now Bean regroups.
Being in as much trouble as Bean was, it's admirable that he's conducting this round as well as he is. I mean, Holyfield should be chasing him all around this ring. You got to give Bean credit. Let's say it again. Give him credit. I was laughing at him. No, I ain't laughing now.
Watch that head, Brad.
Me too.
Watch your head, Amanda. Watch your head.
Bean in a loss here tonight. Stock would still go up 10-4.
No question about it. I started saying that in the fifth round.
This is not a pretty fight. This is one of those very physical fights. A lot of grappling involved.
shots are hard.
Right on the jaw.
Right on the jaw. I mean, you know, the kid's fighting.
No question about that. Take it out back about Vaughn B. This kid has hung in there against the heavyweight champion of the world in the champion's neighborhood. Holyfield. Here comes Holyfield. Right off the top of the head, combination to the head. Right uppercut to the chin. 20 seconds to go.
Should be going, but that clock is winding down. It's inside of 10. He's going to make it again.
Furious attack, though, by Holyfield.
That left right was clean and on the money. And I'll tell you what, Vaughn Bean showed a pretty good chin there.
What a chin.
Indeed.
Come on. Get it out. Get your legs out. Get him out. Come on.
Open up. Open up.
You know what you got to do now?
Spit it up, spit it. Open up, open up.
You got that dance on me. Dance right. Don't get hit with nothing. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Don't get hit with nothing.
Hold it, you're short of smoke. Hold this, please.
Stop trying to load up. Okay. Put your ass.
All right, let's take a look at that first bit of trouble he got into. Not that much trouble because he kept coming back. I mean, he got hit a clean shot, another shot behind the ear, and he's still there. I mean, this has got to be frustrating, Holyfield.
Holyfield right now is pressing. He senses the kill. There's a nice 1-2. Not real clean. A beautiful left uppercut. Keeping his back to the ropes. Keeping the pressure on. Evander cleans up on the inside. That right hand and left right there. They were as clean as he's going to get at this stage of the game, being as tired as they are.
And this is the championship round, number 12.
Evander Holyfield has won 4 fights by knockout in the 12th round. So just keep that in mind as we enter the 12th and final round. Vaughn Bean carrying 231 pounds into this fight, his heaviest ever, and he's carrying it pretty well going into the last round. There's some loose tape on the left wrist of Vaughn Bean.
And they should have taken that between rounds because it was there when he came back to the corner. I don't know why they didn't take care of it right then. Well, in his corner, he's got two of the real heroes of boxing, Joe Frazier and Michael Spinks, both possessed with championship heart. They must have infused this kid with some of that spirit because he's got the spunk and he's got the strength to be still in here with Holyfield. There's Joe Frazier. God bless him. Toughest man I ever saw in the ring.
So here we go.
Oh, he's back to his bounce. He's back to his rhythm.
Well, he's having a good time now. He's ahead. He can't lose this fight.
Vaughn Bean needs the knockout. Who thought we'd even be saying that at this stage?
I, for one, was not convinced we were going to go past round 5. And here we are. A nice heavyweight championship fight with everything in the balance to just round 10 when he got dropped.
Well, you know what? I don't want to burst anybody's bubble, but I don't think we had a great fight here. We had a competitive fight for a few different reasons, but this particular type of fight is an ugly fight for me, from a pure boxing sense.
Whoever thought Holyfield versus Bean would be competitive? There's a right hook by Bean on the top of Holyfield's head. He is just unleashing. He's looking for him. He wants to end it, and that's what he needs to do to win this fight.
Well, he's going to need a knockout. There's no question about that.
And he's not holding back midway through the last round. Vaughn Bean with double left hooks to the head of Evander Holyfield continues to score.
To the body and then to the head and then to the head again. You can't fault this guy. He's trying like heck for this last round. He's not trying to play it safe. He's trying to get his knockout.
Once again, we must give unbelievable credit to Vaughn Bean, who has won over a portion of this crowd.
If you come to Atlanta and chant Bean, you got to be a little on the crazy side anyway.
Final minute of round 12.
So far, Vaughn Bean has won this round. He's done the work. He's pushed the pace. Evander does not look like the Evander of old, but we've said that before. And I'm sure the next time out of the box, something different will happen all over again.
From New Jersey, Jamaica, and Las Vegas.
I tell you who should be interested in this is Tyson. Tyson should be looking at this and saying, oh, this guy's not ready for the pickings.
Nice left hook to the body. Seemed to buckle. Vaughn being a little bit, but, you know, Amanda doesn't have much left on the shots either. This is the end of the night, and he is tired.
Tyson must feel he wishes he got relicensed today and flew to Atlanta to fight Holyfield.
Let me capture this. Holyfield did not impress. Bean did impress.
I don't know that Bean impressed as much as Holyfield was unimpressive.
It doesn't make a difference in Bobby. He impressed because he lasted, and it's a decision.
Good job.
That's it.
Good job, fellas.
Holyfield and Bean embrace. Did you ever believe you'd see 12 rounds between these two fighters?
I would have bet an awful lot against it. I'm glad I didn't bet.
And an exciting 12 rounds for the most part.
I've got Holyfield comfortably ahead. I mean, it would be a shot. You'd have to be in Las Vegas for this to be turned around. But in Atlanta, Georgia, as Bobby pointed out, if Bean won this fight, we'd all have to get under this ring and stay here till tomorrow.
At the same time, if he won the fight, we'd say he won the fight. I don't believe he won the fight.
I don't believe he won it.
He showed 200 or 300% more than I thought he had.
I am 117 to 111. That's a pretty big margin, but that was an 8-10 round there.
Yeah, so 116-111.
It's now in the hands of Al DeVito from...
So, Bobby, we're pretty close.
We usually are not too far.
Wayne, New Jersey, Leroy Brown from Kingston, Jamaica, and Wayne Ford from Las Vegas, Nevada. As they total up the cards, momentarily, our Jimmy Lennon Jr. ring announcer will have the results. Vander Holyfield, who said he wanted to put on a good show and end things quickly, unable to live up to his word. Now he just wants to get a decision, showing a lot of respect there. He showed too much respect for Bean during the fight, showing a lot of respect here afterwards as well, showing sportsmanship.
Well, I'll say that 40,000 people came in here and got their money's worth. They got to see a good championship fight of 12 strong rounds with a surprise.
And a bit of a scare. Can you imagine Holyfield losing in his hometown after a week of celebration to a guy like this? Vaughn Bean. Yeah.
Let's take a look at the only knockdown of the fight. We'll look at it twice. Now watch what happens when he gets in the ropes. He got in trouble with that right hand. That was the first thing. There's an uppercut which didn't do him any good.
Now watch
another
two.
Hook. Now watch as he goes. We'll see this in the second.
Vaughn's just kind of diving into him. Holyfield steps out of the way.
See, now watch. He's tied up and gets hit. See that?
But here's the thing. He was not draped over the ropes. He didn't hit him from behind. It was his sloppiness. It's an overhead look of the same scenario. On the way in, Evander starts getting him with the right uppercut. There's the first one. Gets his attention. See Vaughn trying to just charge and hold. Again, Evander will work him up. There's a hook, and there's another uppercut that's coming up in here soon. There's another hook, and another uppercut somewhere. Okay, this is the uppercut that winds up doing it. Referee wasn't there in time. He wasn't draped through the ropes. He wasn't hanging through the ropes. I think that's a non-issue.
Because he just was sloppy. It is.
We're standing by for the decision. What's going through the mind of Henry Akinwande right now, who could be the next opponent? Him. All right, let's get the results from Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Dwayne Ford, scores about 116 to 111. Judges at ringside, Leroy Brown and Al DeVito, both scored about 117 to 110, all three in favor of the winner, and still heavyweight champion of the world, the pride of Atlanta, Evander, the real deal, Holyfield.
Well, it's not exactly what he had in mind, but he wins by unanimous decision as the balloons drop from the ceiling.
I'd be willing to bet he never goes around promoting his own fight again.
You have a point there, because he probably took a lot out of him. Let's go up into the ring and Jim Gray. Jim.
All right. Thank you very much, Steve. We have both fighters right here. First, let's start with you, Evander Holyfield. Congratulations. However, this was certainly not the easy fight that many people had predicted. Were you overconfident tonight?
No, I wasn't overconfident. I was fighting a guy that was inspired. You know, I'm the guy that everybody fight. And, you know, the man fought a good fight. I hit him with good shots. He was able to take that combination. I went through everything that I knew to do to win.
But you didn't underestimate him.
But no, I don't underestimate nobody. And I thank the Lord, Jesus Christ, for giving me the strength to stick to a game plan.
Evander, coming into this fight, absolutely nobody thought that Von Bean should even be fighting you. Was this one of your off nights, or was this a signal that maybe at 35 years of age, is this maybe the night that you got old?
Well, not at all. Yeah, you have to give the man credit.
That's right.
This man came to fight. Right. If this is what, now that's what I love about boxing, because regardless of what everybody else's opinion about a person, it's their job to come in and fight, and he proved that tonight. He went 12 rounds. A lot of good fighters hadn't been able to go 12. And he proven that he had what it take to go 12.
Did he ever at any point hurt you tonight?
Well, he hit me with good shots. I had to respect him. My coach asked me why I wasn't jabbing, but you know, he was doing different things and stuff. I wasn't able to. He got a good rhythm that he's able to slip more jab. He's more of a better boxer than what a lot of people give him credit for, because they haven't seen a lot of him.
Hey, let's take a look at this monitor if we can get it in here. Bring the monitor over in here. Looks as though a couple of times, in this instance right here, Von Bean gets some good shots on you. Tell us about it.
Well, you know, of course, he get good shots. One thing is he's competitive. One thing I like about people, when people don't take nothing for granted, this is his day to shine. And it just goes out the heavyweight champion. I became the heavyweight champion because I felt that I could win. He felt that he could win. It was a competitive fight. Can't take nothing from the man.
Now in the 10th round, he went down.